Dear colleagues, my name is Clementi Cherikovsky. I am staff scientist of the Analytical Chemistry Co-Laboratory of King Abdullah University of Science and Technology. Today, I am pleased to announce that our laboratory starts a series of technician seminar sessions devoted to the different methods of analysis applied in analytical chemistry and used in our laboratory. But before we start the session, please read the main rules of our webinar and let me say a couple of words about our laboratory. The Analytical Chemistry Co-Lab supports research at CALS and regionally by providing customized techniques and expertise for chemical analysis in a user-driven environment. The Analytical Chemistry Co-Lab includes four teams: inorganic analysis, chromatography and mass spectrometry, surface analysis and spectroscopy, and environmental analysis. Our laboratory provides next types of services: instrument training, independent use, full service, collaboration. Also, the laboratory works in partnership with CALS faculty, students and staff, industrial partners, government, local universities. And at last, dear colleagues, now I am pleased to introduce to you one of the most effective methods of elemental analysis: inductively coupled plasma mass spectrometry. In frames of this webinar, you will get information about the main principles and application of this method. First of all, I'm going to share with you the general information about ICP-MS method and describe the main types of ICP-MS spectrometer. Then I would like to bring the common principles of the method to your attention, describing the key parts of ICP-MS spectrometer and challenges of the method. And at last, I will describe the main applications of ICP-MS method, focusing on the applications in our environmental laboratory. Inductively coupled plasma mass spectrometry is an instrumental analytical technique for trace elemental analysis based on the use of a high temperature ionization source coupled to a mass spectrometer. To carry out elemental analysis using ICP-MS method, it is necessary to perform next steps: generate an aerosol of the sample using nebulizer, ionize sample in the inductively coupled plasma, extract ions in this interface, separate ions by mass filter, detect ions by electron multiplier, and finally calculate the concentrations, usually using calibration curves. Currently, the ICP-MS method is the most sensitive among the major atomic spectroscopy techniques. Detection limit achieves the concentrations less than nanogram per liter. It is significantly better than the previous most sensitive method atomic absorption with graphite furnace can offer. Except high sensitivity, ICP-MS method provides the next advantages: determination of almost all elements of the periodic table, high stability, wide range, dynamic range, high throughput. At the present time, the ICP-MS method is very popular and widely used in analytical laboratories. There are three main types of design of the ICP-MS instrument based on different mass analyzers: quadrupole, sector field, and time of flight. There are two types of quadrupole ICP-MS spectrometers: single quadrupole and triple quadrupole. In first type of spectrometers, a mass analyzer includes a collision reaction cell and one quadrupole mass filter. In second type, the design of the mass analyzer includes two quadrupole mass filters and the collision reaction cell between them. The quadrupole mass filter allows to select analyzed ions according to their mass to charge ratio and first scan ions in mass sequence from low mass to high mass. The standard configuration of all modern quadrupole ICP-MS spectrometers includes the collision reaction cell. The next type of ICP-MS spectrometers, which I'm going to describe, is high resolution ICP-MS. Modern high resolution spectrometers make use double focusing sector mass analyzer based on reverse near Johnson geometric position of a magnetic field and electrostatic analyzer. The electrostatic analyzer is behind the magnetic field. The ion beam is dispersed in the field of the electromagnet by mass and energy and focuses on output. Then, passing through the electrostatic analyzer, ion beam is filtered out by ion's energy and focuses on the exit slit. Thus, a high mass spectral resolution is achieved. Due to describing its construction, this type of mass spectrometer has except high resolution, extra two advantages over quadrupole ICP-MS. Significantly lower detection limit for most of elements and extended number of elements which can be measured. But there are some disadvantages, high price and long time of analysis. The mass analyzer of multi-collector ICP-MS spectrometer is also a double focusing magnetic sector, but based on direct near Johnson geometric position of a magnetic field and an electrostatic analyzer. The magnetic field is behind the electrostatic analyzer. Plus, in this instrument, a conventional detector is replaced on multi-collector module, which allows simultaneously detect elements. This type of spectrometer includes all advantages of high-resolution ICP-MS spectrometer, plus extremely improves accuracy and precision isotope ratio determination and decreases the time of analysis. And at last, let me say a few words about inductively coupled plasma time-of-flight mass spectrometer. In time-of-flight mass analyzer, ion's mass-to-charge ratio is determined via a time-of-flight measurement. Ions are accelerated by an electric field and the acceleration results all ions have the same kinetic energy, but different velocity dependent on mass-to-charge ratio. Consequently, the time-of-flight will depend on mass-to-charge ratio. Modern ICP-TOF-MS spectrometers combines the ICP ion optics collision reaction cell and vacuum system of quadrupole spectrometers with a node filter, additional ion optics and orthogonal acceleration analyzer. ICP-TOF-MS spectrometers provide high mass resolution, precise isotope ratio, high speed detection and excellent sensitivity. As 90% of all ICP-MS spectrometers, which are used in laboratories over the world, are quadrupole mass spectrometers. Today, we will consider the principles and applications of this type of spectrometers. The key parts of ICP-MS spectrometer are introduction system, plasma, interface, ion lenses, collision reaction cell, mass filter, and detector. Let's consider in details each part to get the main principles of quadrupole ICP-MS method. First part of ICP-MS spectrometer is simple introduction system. There are different ways how a simple can transport into a plasma. A liquid simple introduction system is used most often. Also, there is such name hyphenated technique when two analytical instruments are coupled and one is used as a simple introduction system. The ICP-MS spectrometers coupled with laser is very popular now. This analytical technique is widely used for direct determination of major and trace element concentrations and isotopic ratio in solid samples. For speciation analysis, chromatographic instruments are used as the simple introduction system. Chromatographic columns allow to separate analytes and transport them into a plasma in different time. I propose to consider each of these types of simple introduction system slowly. Simples most commonly are introduced into a plasma as liquids. It means the simple before analysis has to be dissolved according to a simple preparation procedures. Liquid containing dissolved elements is transported into the plasma due to a peristatic pump and a pneumatic or ultrasonic nebulizers. The most popular types of pneumatic nebulizers are concentric, cross-flow, and high-air solids. The design of concentric nebulizers allows to produce a fine mist from liquid samples. On one hand, concentric nebulizers offer excellent precision and detection limit. On another hand, these nebulizers should never be used with solutions containing suspended solids. Cross-flow nebulizers are not so delicate as concentric nebulizers. This type of nebulizer often is used when it is necessary to analyze the solution with high concentration of total dissolved solids, or when the optimum in precision and detection limit is of less importance than having a large sample load capability. Cross-flow nebulizer is not recommended also if suspended particles are present. For this case, there is a high-risk solids nebulizer. The design of the high solid nebulizer includes the construction materials that resist the hydrofluoric acid and the caustic attack. In general, the high solid nebulizer provides moderate detection limit and precision. In ultrasonic nebulizers, sound is used instead of a gas as the energy source for converting a liquid to a fine mist. Ultrasonic nebulizer improves the detection limits roughly by a factor of 10, but it is significantly more expensive. The laser ablation is a process of generation of fine particles from a simple surface by focused laser beam. LA-ICP-MS analysis begins with this process. Then the ablated particles are transported into a plasma of the ICP-MS instrument. The main advantages of this method are possibility to carry out high sensitive chemical analysis without any sample preparation. Samples can be both conducting and non-conducting, and the analysis can be performed in the air. LA-ICP-MS method delivers the fastest analysis speed of all analytical techniques. And finally, the simple mass size required for LA-ICP-MS analysis is submicroscale, picograms to femtograms. A liquid chromatography ICP-MS is most often used heat-treated system for speciation analysis. Some elements, depending on the chemical forms in which they exist, can be either toxic or not toxic. For example, there are such toxic forms of elements as chromium, 4-valence, arsenic, 3- and 5-valence, or methyl mercury. A chromatography column is used to separate all forms from each other. The exit time of analyzed species from the column varies and depends on their affinity to stationary phase. Consequently, during time resolution analysis, we register all species separately as chromatography spectrum. LC-ICP-MS method has wide applicability, offers high sensitivity, high selectivity, high reproducibility, and provides rapid and quantitative analysis. The plasma is a source of ions in ICP-MS techniques. As soon as an aerosol enters into a plasma, its particles undergo vaporization, atomization, ionization, and partial recombination. The efficiency of all these processes depends on inductively coupled plasma characteristics, aerosol chemical content, and a size content and the size of aerosol particles. The general plasma characteristics are plasma temperature and electron density. This characteristic directly impacts on ionization coefficient of atoms. This effect is mathematically described by the Sacher equation. From this equation, it follows the coefficient of ionization is higher than higher the plasma temperature and lower electron density. Also, the Sach equation shows that the ionization coefficient depends on ionization energy of ionization potential by another mode. The ICP-MS interface is the region where the ions generated in the plasma are transferred from atmospheric pressure to the vacuum region and introduced to the mass spectrometer as an ion beam. The interface located between a pair of conical metal plates known as interface cones, simple and skinner. These cones are responsible for the intensity and stability of an analytical signal. If there are damages of cones holes or a build-up of deposits on the cones, the intensity and stability of the signal reduce. In this case, it is necessary to clean or replace these cones. After interface, ion beam moves through ion lenses. Independent of manufacture, this part of ICP-MS spectrometer can be designed and named by different ways. For example, ion lenses, ion optics, ion mirror. But in spite of such difference, the main aim of this part of spectrometer is the same, to separate ion beam and natural particles, compounds and photons to protect high vacuum region from contaminations and minimize background noise on the detector. The figure on this slide shows the common scheme of alginate ICP-MS spectrometer. The extraction lens focuses the ions as they enter the intermediate vacuum stage, providing high ion transmission through the mass range. Off-axis omega lens separate neutral species from the ion beam and direct ions into a high plasma region. Initially, ion beam after passing ion lenses was entering into a quadruple mass filter. But at the end of the last century, there appears a first prototype of modern collision reaction cell. The cell was placed in the high vacuum region of mass spectrometer before quadruple mass filter. It was a turning point in the development of ICP-MS spectrometry. The using collision reaction cell was a cheap solution of the biggest problem of quadruple ICP-MS spectrometers, polyatomic interferences. As soon as the commercial ICP-MS instrument with collision reaction cell was produced, their number in analytical laboratories and the number of publications devoted to development of ICP-MS method were extremely increased. Currently, the collision reaction cell is an integral part of all quadruple ICP-MS spectrometers. The modern collision reaction cell works in two modes. Reaction mode uses specific reaction gases to remove non-reactive interferences for each analyte isotope. Collision mode uses a non-reactive gas and a process called kinetic energy discrimination to selectively attenuate all polyatomic interferences based on their size. Each mode will be considered separately a little bit later. Quadruple mass filter is the heart of ICP-MS spectrometer. Quadruple mass filter separates the ions according to their mass to charge ratio and first scans ions in mass sequence from a low mass to a high mass. Quadruple mass filter consists of four metal rods set parallel to each other. Two opposite rods have an applied positive potential and the other two have a negative potential, alternating and direct voltage are applied to opposite pairs of rods. For given alternate and direct voltages, only ions of a certain mass to charge ratio pass through the quadruple filter and all other ions throw out of their original path. A detector is the last part of ICP-MS instrument. Analog and digital detectors are used with ICP-MS. Analog detector is Faraday cap. When high velocity ions hit the Faraday cap, an electrical current is produced, which is proportional to the number of impacting ions. Faraday caps require a relatively large number of ions to produce a measurable signal, and so cannot be used to detect single ion. However, they are extremely stable and suited to precision isotope pressure measurements performed by multi-collector ICP-MS instruments. Digital detectors are discrete and continuous diode electron multipliers. Secondary electron emission is used to multiply the charge of the incident ion beam, increasing sensitivity of the mass spectrometer dramatically. Electron multipliers can detect even single ions coming from the mass analyzer. This type of detector is widely used with quadruple ICP-MS. For example, arginine ICP-MS spectrometers use a dual mode discrete diode electron multiplier that provides a full 9-10 order dynamic range under standard operating conditions. What does dual mode mean? It means the detector uses two modes, pulse and analog. In pulse mode, voltage is applied to each electron multiplier stage and each pulse is counted. In analog mode, part of the detector is turned off and the signal is read by a sensitive current meter. To get linear response over a wide range of signal intensities, it is necessary to match pulse signal with analog signal. For this purpose, there is a special PA factor adjustment procedure, which is performed automatically and produces cross-calibration coefficient PA factors for each analyzed element. After the introduction of the main principles of ICP-MS analysis, I want to talk about common problem of all instrumental methods of analysis, including ICP-MS, about matrix effect and issues which it causes. There are two types of matrix effect. Matrix induces spectral overlap problems, spectral interferences, plus matrix induces signal intensity changes, physical and chemical interferences. Physical interferences affect how much of the sample gets to the spectrometer. Chemical interferences affect the nature of plasma or analytes in the plasma. Let's see all types of interferences in detail and ways how we can minimize them. The physical interferences are caused by the matrix via solution transport and nebulization changes, creating of space charge and salt buildup on the cones. Space charge effect is a phenomenon of defocusing the ion beam, especially light elements in it. Since cations experience Coulombic forces and mutually repel one another, the space charge effect is particularly severe when the matrix ions have a heavier mass than the analyte ions. To minimize the physical interferences, we have to use one of the next ways: to dilute sample, use internal standard, or do matrix matching of standard with samples. The chemical interferences are caused by the matrix via the changes of analyte ionization, molecular compound formation, and aerosol vaporization in plasma. To minimize this type of interferences, we can use one of the listed above ways plus optimize operation condition of the instrument. Spectral interferences include isobaric interferences when different elements have isotopes isotopes with the same mass, polyatomic interferences when polyatomic compounds created in plasma have the same mass as analyzed isotope, and at last, double charge ion interferences when some isotopes of elements with low second ionization potential can be doubly ionized and consequently interfere the signal of once ionized isotopes with mass twice less. To minimize the isobaric interferences, we can choose another isotope of analyte or use the correction equation of high resolution ICP-MS spectrometer. To minimize polyatomic interferences, we can use always listed above plus optimize operation conditions and use collision reaction cell. All listed above ways can be applied to minimize double charge ion interferences. As I mentioned before, the biggest problem of ICP-MS spectrometry is polyatomic interferences. The using of collision reaction cell commonly resolves this problem. And now I want briefly to consider the main principles of cell work in reaction and collision modes. In reaction mode, specific reaction gases, ammonia, hydrogen, oxygen, etc., are used to remove non-reactive interferences from each analyte isotope. As a result of using reaction gases, on one hand, this mode is an effective and selective. On another hand, new potential polyatomic interferences can be created in the cell. On this figure, you can see as reactive gas ammonia eliminates polyatomic interferences argon oxide from iron isotope. The reaction of ammonia with argon oxide forms atomic oxygen and argon together with a positive ammonia ion. All these products cannot pass the mass filter adjusted for mass 56. Additionally, this example demonstrates a high effective of the reaction mode. As iron ions don't react with ammonia gas, their number doesn't decrease so dramatically as number of argon oxide ions after the cell pass. The work principle of collision mode is different to reaction mode and based on process called kinetic energy discrimination. Collision mode uses a non-reactive gas helium, which interacts via collision with both polyatomic interferences and analyte ions. Since all polyatomic ions are larger than analyte ions of the same mass, they collide with the cell gas more often as they pass through the cell, losing significantly more energy than analyte ions. In this way, there appears kinetic energy discrimination between analyte ions and polyatomic interferences. The low energy ions are excluded from the ion beam by a bias voltage at the cell exit. In this manner, the collision cell reduces all polyatomic interferences. Obviously, the some part of analyte ions with low energy cannot leave the cell also. For this reason, generally, the collision mode is less effective than reaction mode. However, the collision mode is a universal and don't create new interferences. Because of these properties, in practice, the collision mode is used more often than reaction mode. At the end of this part of my presentation, I would like to say a few words about the last generation of ICP-MS quadrupole instruments, about triple quadrupole ICP-MS spectrometer. In this instrument, collision reaction cell is placed between two quadrupole mass filters. The main benefit of such design is the possibility of complete elimination of polyatomic and double charge ion interferences. To understand how it is possible, let's consider next example. It is necessary to analyze arsenic at the presence of polyatomic and double charge ions interferences. If first quadrupole mass filter is adjusted to pass only ions with mass to charge ratio 75, all ions with another ratio are rejected. Using oxygen as reactive reaction gas in collision reaction cell, we get arsenic oxide at the cell exit. If second quadrupole mass filter is adjusted to pass only ions with mass to charge ratio 91, all potential interferences are rejected in it, as they have mass to charge ratio 75, and the signal of arsenic oxides can be registered without interferences. The second part of the presentation is devoted to ICP-MS method applications in environmental laboratory. But before to start, I would like to say a couple of words about ICP-MS method applications in general. At present time, ICP-MS spectrometry is used widely in many branches of human life. In pharmaceutical, ICP-MS method is used for elemental analysis of different medicine. ICP-MS analysis of hair, nails, and blood is very popular in medical. Due to high sensitivity, this method is not replaceable in semiconductor industry. ICP-MS coupled with laser has a wide range of archaeological applications, including the analysis of ceramic surface and ancient glass. ICP-MS instruments are also applied for food analysis, for analysis of geological and environmental samples, and for judicial expertise. In our environmental lab, ICP-MS method is applied for analysis of drinking and sea waters, biological samples such as mangrove leaves, shrimp, and fish tissue, fish brain, gills, and liver. Also, we can do elemental analysis of sediments, soil, and corals, plus speciation analysis of arsenic and mercury in biological samples. If you don't mind, I will briefly tell you about each type of listed analysis. Analysis of drinking water is the easiest analysis, and it covers the biggest number of analyzed elements, 27. As drinking water doesn't depend on a special simple preparation, we just acidify sample to match with calibration standards and has low matrix. Physical and chemical interferences are negligible weak. The number of spectral interferences is low. All polyatomic interferences are created based on argon and nitrogen and is eliminated in collision mode. Analysis of seawater is more complete than drinking water, as the matrix of seawater is 3% of sodium chloride. This matrix produces extremely strong physical and chemical interferences and high amount of spectral interferences. To analyze such samples without special simple preparation, we use a C-fast introduction system. This system works in three different modes: pre-concentration, hydride, and direct. The pre-concentration mode uses a special column to remove matrix elements and accumulate trace elements. Thanks to this, the detection limit of many elements in seawater can achieve nanograms per liter. The hydride mode is used for the analysis of a few elements only, which can create stable and volatile hydride compounds. These compounds are separated from matrix and transported directly into a plasma. The sensitivity of analysis in hydride mode is close to the sensitivity in pre-concentration mode. Unfortunately, significantly less sensitivity can be provided by a direct mode. As in this mode, analyzed samples are simply automatically diluted, generally in 10 times. Unlike drinking and seawater, biological samples need a special simple preparation. These samples must be digested in microwave digestion system with using nitric acid. In our laboratory, we use milestone digestion system, which provides the simultaneous digestion of 40 samples. After digestion, all samples are transferred into new tubes and diluted with DI water. The matrix of analyzed sample is high acidified water. To minimize physical and chemical differences, internal standards and optimized operation conditions are used. The using of collision and reaction modes helps to dramatically reduce polyatomic interferences. The procedure of sediment sample preparation is almost the same as described before for biological samples. The main difference is the next. The procedure of digestion of each sediment sample has to be performed twice. One portion has to be digested with nitric and hydrofluoric acids for determination of minor elements, and another portion has to be digested with nitric acid only for determination of major elements. Also, as concentration both minor and major elements in sediments is high, all digestion solutions have to be diluted additionally in 50 times for minor elements analysis and in 1,000 times for major elements analysis. The additional dilution of samples allows to reduce the matrix effect, especially spectral interferences. At the end of the presentation, it is necessary to say a couple of words about mercury and arsenic speciation analysis in biological samples. This type of analysis is performed using ICP-MS spectrometer coupled with liquid chromatograph. Before analysis, the biological samples undergo a treatment. First of all, they have to be dried. The dried samples are placed into a special solution to extract analyzed species. For each type of species, arsenic and mercury, a specific extract solution is applied. As I have described before, the main principles of this type of analysis. Now, I just want to note that in our laboratory, we analyzed two species of mercury, including most deadly form methyl mercury, and four species of arsenic, including high toxic inorganic form. Thank you for your attention. Please feel free to ask me any questions and send them to my email.